This week on My Classic Car. We'll travel to Beloit, Wisconsin for the Beloit Autorama. The range of rides at this event makes it one of the coolest places for car nuts in the Midwest. You're gonna love it.
Hi, I'm Dennis Gage. Thanks for tuning in to My Classic Car, home of the certified car nut. Well, this week I'm in southern Wisconsin at the Beloit Autorama. This event is in its 30th year and it typically draws about 1,000 cars here in Preservation Park on the shores of the Rock River. You can see just about everything here, so what do you say we get around to check a few of these babies out?
Well, Kevin, this is a nice 57 Chev. It's a, you know, needs a little work, kind of a daily driver.
Well, thank you, Dennis. It's a lot of fun, sort of my dual quad daily driver here.
But it's really your tow vehicle, right?
That's right. It tows real well.
Because it's a nice car, but it's what you're towing that sucked me in. This is incredible.
Well, thank you.
What is this?
I get a kick out of this. It's a 58 Glastron Seaflight. This was something that you just don't see very often.
Well, I've never seen, actually. It's like a car turned into a boat, but it's not. I mean, it's just purpose-built this way, right?
Yeah, I've had people ask me how I was able to weld the fins from a car onto that boat. And since it's fiberglass,
it's really,
I guess it's all in the welding garage.
Yeah, it's hard to weld fiberglass. And you know, the bench seats on the other side. I mean, this would be a blast to be out in a lake.
It is, yeah. I take it out fairly often. It's an 80 horse, so it'll do about 30 to 35, depending on load.
Wow.
It'll tow skiers.
It's awesome. But this isn't the only one you brought, right?
Oh,
you
have no, but wait, there's more.
But wait, there's more. Let's go check it out.
All right. Yeah.
I thought the other one was wild. This is totally insane. What
isn't
is
that
this?
Fun? Well, thank you. This is a 1956 Lonestar Meteor.
A lot of wild details. I mean, these cast headlight eyebrows.
Yeah, yeah. You know, a lot of castings on this boat. They're very expensive.
So a combination, again, of automotive and nautical.
Yes.
And the cockpit is...
That is original design. The seats are exactly the same pattern. The side panels are slightly different. But this is how they were made. Of course, they were generally made in black and red that year. Uh-huh. This one, I just
pink.
Couldn't help but think, yes.
How many did they make of these?
With no records, our best guess is they were in the hundreds, the low hundreds.
Well, I've sure never seen one. And wild fins, I mean, obviously, 50s
yeah,
car influence here.
They sure look like the 51 Buick LeSabre to me.
Well, I tell you, you know, I admire you for collecting these and preserving these, because this is really... you know, some 50s history here and quite an interesting melding of automotive and marine.
Yeah, yeah, it's really something that we never saw before and we'll never see again, I suspect.
Take care of him, man. So until our next meeting, remember, honor the timeless classics. I'm Dennis Gage. Happy motoring.